Even if you don't know its name, you've seen it. The classic circle that slowly shrinks down at the end of a movie. It is one of the most iconic film transitions there is, but also one that is barely used today. It honestly feels like a thing of the past, and despite of that, we all just somehow know it, without thinking too much about. And since thinking too much about things is sort of what I do, this is the story of a true staple of cinema. It all started when I was watching The Departed, and not even 10 minutes in, I found myself thinking more about the transition than the movie itself. It felt very unusual, yet familiar, and considering it's Martin Scorsese, I just knew it had to be there for a reason. So I looked it up, and it turns out it's called the iris shot, and there are two main types: iris in when it is opening a scene, and iris out when it's closing it. Back in the day, it was actually done manually, when they would put an iris diaphragm in front of the camera and slowly move it to get the effect. Some of the earliest examples I could find are in the movies of D.W. Griffith, but the real credit should actually be given to his close collaborator and camera operator, the cinematographer Billy Bitzer. There is surprisingly little information about this online, but I managed to get my hands on a copy of his autobiography, and sure enough, he talks about the exact day he came up with this invention. It must have been sometime in 1913. As he describes it, he was on a lunch break during the filming of a movie when he noticed that two of the actors sitting across from him have been illuminated by the sun in a particularly beautiful manner. So he grabbed his camera to film a little test, and to prevent the sunlight from causing lens flares, he shaded the side of the lens with his hat. D.W. Griffith, who was directing the movie, really liked the footage and encouraged him to keep experimenting, but because the hat would sometimes get into the shots, he tried to make it a bit more sturdy by cutting a hole in a can of glue and putting that in front of the lens. It worked nicely, and it was one of the earliest examples of backlit shots, but something he didn't account for was that the can of glue would cause the film to darken in the corners. And in fact, when the lab technicians developed the film, they called him because they thought his camera was broken, but at this point, both him and D.W. Griffith saw it as less of a mistake and more of a technique that would help direct the viewer's attention. The studio executives liked it too, because it made the film look sophisticated, but Billy Bitzer didn't just stop there. He then took it to the next level by grabbing an iris diaphragm, a mechanical part that he took from an old camera, and using that in front of the lens. So not only he could precisely control the opening, but do so while the camera is still rolling. It was the invention of the iris shot, and over the following years, and especially during the 1920s, it became a widely popular technique. For one, it allowed to highlight the emotion of the character, but what's even more, it was a great way to put an emphasis on an important detail of the scene. After all, it was the silent era, everything had to be communicated visually, and the iris shot was essentially a spotlight that the director could use to carefully guide your attention throughout the story. It was so popular that even the animated movies would use it, but by the 1930s, it was already considered old school. On top of that, the development of sound and more sophisticated editing led to the iris shot feeling outdated, and by the mid-20th century, it was mostly used in cartoons and movies paying homage to the classics. But despite of that, it still had its place in cinema. It was a cultural phenomenon that almost had its own personality. The characters would interact with it, trying to stop it from closing. It would chase them around and wait for one last line before it closes. It would even change shapes to reflect the feeling of the story, and while a lot of movies would use it ironically for comedic effect, there's still some out there who use it for its original purpose, and I wanted to try it out too. The old school way.